got swag, we got swag. I got, you got, we got swag, we got swag. And we say with the, and we say with the, and we say with amazing grace. And we say with the, and we say with the, and we say with amazing grace. Say with amazing grace.
Hi everyone, it's Kristen, also known as the professor, and I'm here for this swag moment. I got no reason to fear, I got Jesus on my side. Now today, we are kind of fast-forwarding a little bit with Genesis. We are looking at Genesis 37 through 50 and the story of Joseph. Now, many of you might know of Joseph. He's the really cool dude that had the beautiful coat that he got from his dad. He also starts the story with Joseph getting this dream where he learns that he's going to be a leader, right? He's given this vision, and God has given him his purpose of being this leader. And many of us would think, awesome, Joseph is going to go from dream to promotion to blessed to palace and being this amazing leader. But that's not how it works in Genesis. Actually, it's quite the opposite. Joseph goes from dream to then being betrayed by his brothers and sold into slavery. And then once he's a slave, he ends up, you know, kind of working in his master's house, becoming his second or right-hand man. And then once again, he gets put in jail because the wife of his master lies on him and says that Joseph was trying to get with her. What? So poor Joseph goes from being sold into slavery, then thrown into jail on a charge that was bogus. And then from jail, he goes to palace. If I was Joseph, I'd be upset. It really hurt. And it's really easy in those situations where, like we are right now, is to be like, God, I don't get this. I don't get all this anger. I don't get all this frustration. I don't get all this fear. I don't get the pandemic. Why are we in this situation? Instead, God is asking us to focus on the what. What are we supposed to learn in this situation? How are we going to be better through this? So because Joseph, while he was betrayed and sold into slavery, practice the what. What did he need to learn? Well, he learned how to run a household. And because he knew how to learn to run a household, later on when he had to run a nation, he already had those skills. Because Joseph, while he was being betrayed, was sent to another country, which was going to have the resources to have the extra food that was going to feed his family, he had the transportation to move to that elevation. Because while he was in jail, Joseph was able to make that partnership later on with people who were going to elevate him to the palace. Joseph had that networking ability that he never would have had if he was back home with his brothers. During this time, it's really easy to focus on the how we got here and to really point fingers about all the things that are wrong. But God wants to teach us what we can do. There's a lot you can do. You can vote. You can encourage others to vote. You can march peacefully. You can share on your Instagram or TikTok or other social medias. There is so much that you guys can do. And I really want you to know that, like, knowledge is power. So don't be afraid to ask questions, to read, and to get informed. I'm so proud of everyone, and I really hope that these next couple of weeks that we don't get down on the how we got here, but we take our feelings and emotions and focus on the what we can do to make it better. I have so much hope for the future, and I'm excited to see what not only happens in our city and our state and our nation and in our world. I'm so excited to see what you do. Because just like Joseph, I know even in a bad situation, God is going to bless you and cover you and just elevate you to greatness. So let's work together to be great. I ask you to quiet your hearts while I pray over you. Dear Heavenly Father, I just thank you for this opportunity to speak into the young minds of our children here. Dear Heavenly Father, cover them, protect them. Give them the courage to ask those hard questions and the wisdom to find the answers. please let them know that they have so many options to create positive change in the world. I know they can do it, and with your help, they are going to go from dream to palace. Continue to pour into them, and I pray all this in your son's name. Amen. I'm so proud of every single one of you. As this summer goes on, I'm excited to see how each and every one of you are continuing to study Genesis. We've learned so much already, and I can't wait to learn so much more. You guys all have a great week. Be blessed and be safe.